Hey, I'm Jason. This is All Things Random. This is Sunday, episode number 4. Today we're getting in the fourth watch in my collection, something I'm probably never going to get rid of, and that is my Ballast Trafalgar. Now, this was given to me a few years ago by my family because that's what I wanted for Christmas, was this Ballast Trafalgar. In fact, when this thing first came out, it was like $500, almost $600 in some places. Now you can get it for like $300 on Amazon. Now, there's a lot of things that I like about this watch. Now, it is a little bit large on the wrist. To be honest, it is 47 millimeters in diameter, so it's not gonna fit a lot of wrists, but I really like the way this thing looks, and I also like the way the mechanism works. Now, this does have a Miyota 821521 jewel automatic movement, but that's not the cool thing about it. The cool thing is how it winds, how the hours adjust, and how the date adjusts. So let's just go right into how this thing functions, and let's take a look at it on the wrist. Now again, 47 millimeters in diameter. It is slightly thick, but not really overly thick. We'll say 14 millimeters is what it looks like, and it has a lug width of 22 millimeters. So the strap is slightly large, but you can still find anything for it. It's not nearly as large as a Panerai with a strap width of 24 millimeters. So when you're thinking about, you know, dimension sizes, this is about like a 47 millimeter Panerai if you're familiar with the Luminor. Now, the thing that I really like about this is it doesn't have a screw down crown necessarily. It does have a screw down canteen. And the way it functions is it has a push button underneath the canteen. You press it once and it adjusts the day, and then you hit it again and it adjusts the time. Now, the way it's adjusted is by rotating the bezel. This is what I love the most about this watch. You slightly rotate the bezel clockwise, and you can see that that date flips over in the date function. Hit it again, like I said, and then you can adjust the time. Makes everything super easy. I really like when people think outside the box. I love when companies think outside the box, because anybody can do a basic three-handed watch with a date. Anybody can do a basic Miyota 8215 and make it general with a crown at the 3 o'clock position that maybe has a screw down crown, and then offers the basic functions that we're all familiar with in the watch world. It takes a little more design, a little more skill to do something like this. Not only does it adjust everything through the bezel, but this also features 100 meters of water resistance, which to me says a lot. It could be 30 meters of water resistance. Of course, the name Ballast is the ballast tanks in like a submarine, and you can even see on this, it does have a submarine periscope sort of in the actual ballast symbol right there at the 9 o'clock, and it does have a submarine on the buckle as well. So clearly it has to have some water resistance rating. This is by no means a dive watch, but 100 meters is more than anybody needs to even go snorkeling, swimming in the ocean, swimming in a pool. You really don't have to worry about that stuff. Now, this is one of my favorite watches. I also like the fact that the outside just looks sort of aged, torn, and tattered. It's a bronze look without the bronze. Now, honestly, I don't know if I'll ever get rid of this watch simply because of the sentimental value of it. I don't wear it as much as I used to, but that's sort of how watch collections go. The bigger your collection is, the less you are to spend time on a single watch, which is why a lot of people generally tell you, if you're getting into watches, get one good all-around watch and then slowly build up your collection. In fact, I am doing the opposite. I am limiting my collection down because I feel like I need to wear the watches that I have. Now, we're gonna do sort of an update for the future, and then I'm gonna get into a topic that a lot of people may not like, and I may lose some subscribers over it. But at this point, I really don't care, because things need to be said, and it's extremely important that you guys know my position. So first, we're gonna get into a channel update. I am gonna be doing a strap comparison video coming up in the future. I have three different tiers of leather straps I'm gonna be testing out. First is going to be the cheapest strap that I was able to find that still seems like it has a good enough quality, about $18. Next, if you watch any type of YouTubers that are into watches, Teddy Balthasar is one of the ones that a lot of people watch, over 200,000 subscribers, and he's been on for quite a while. He has his own straps that I got myself. This was $40. And again, if you watch watch videos, you of course know Adrian from Bark and Jack. I ordered that. Is the most expensive strap I ordered. All of them are very similar in their style with the distressed leather, with the stitching. I wanted to compare three different price tiers, and the Bark and Jack came in at £69, which is like $94 in US dollars with shipping to get here. So we got a $20, a $40, and an $80 to $90 strap. Coming in the future, keep a lookout for that video coming up, because it's extremely important that we understand what quality is. And if you tell me you have quality, I wanna know that you actually do have quality. Now, what's the last thing that I'm gonna talk about that may piss a lot of people off? Well, I'll be honest with you, we're in sort of a weird time in the world, especially in America, especially when it comes to police officers. Now, I love my wife more than anything else in the world, and I had to say something about something she got me. She got me this coffee mug with a thin blue line custom flag on it. I was really surprised. I was really pleased. She actually has a mug that says, I F the police, and it says she's Mrs. my last name. And it's funny because I'm a police officer and she does F the police. It's supposed to be funny. Anyway, I wanted to give her a shout out because I love how she does things like this for me. And in this type of environment right now where I go and I do my job as a police officer in the busiest city in Alaska, it's ranked the most dangerous city per capita in 2017 by FBI statistics. So I leave my house every single day knowing that I could get into some real trouble out there and I may not return home. And it really sucks because 99.9% of all police in the US do their job 100% of the time, 100% correctly. And it sucks that we're in this sort of back and forth pull where I don't even feel like my own community supports me. And that sort of sucks, but I wanted to get that out there. And I'm probably gonna lose some subscribers because everybody's in the defund police platform. Everybody listens to social media, everybody listens to the news, but they don't live the life of a police officer, and that's sort of what sucks. But again, it really does make me feel good when my wife does stuff like this for me, because I used to do a lot for her. I find that I'm doing less for her, which is a shame because I really need to pick up my game and do more sort of like she does for me. Now, if you like videos and videos like this, I got a couple review videos coming up next week. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, give me a like, hit that notification bell so you guys can be notified when I drop my next video. Until next time.